Hello, hello, everyone. I hope you guys can see. All right, welcome to your strength and stress class. We got a little mix of some upper and lower body exercises today. We're going to move right through them. We're going to do all three sets in a row before we move to our next exercise. We're going to start with our upper body first. So we're going to warm up our arms. So if you are ready, if you have some dumbbells close by, if you have a somewhat heavier pair and then a light pair, feel free to keep them close. And we're going to start with just some steps side to side. And then go ahead and roll those shoulders back. We have our bicep curls first. So we're going to really stretch out those arms. Start to make those circles a little bit bigger. Feel free to just have a nice wide stance with the feet. Come into a nice steady position. And reverse that direction. Bring them up. Nice little bend with the knees. One more. Bring it up. Interlock the hands together. Give it a nice big stretch up. Hands come behind, pull the shoulders down and back. There you go. Take that right arm, bring it across. Pull that arm in close to your chest. And same thing on the other side. We're going to do three different types of bicep curls today. We're going to start with our regular bicep curls, and then we're going to go into wide curls and then hammer curls. So three different types. Let's take it into a little plank position. Let's walk it out into a downward dog. Get a little bit more stretching here. Get our bodies a little bit more warm. So walk it out into your plank. Start to fire up that core. Bring those hips up into the air. Press through those shoulders. And bring it back down to your plank. Just can't make it all alone. Back up to downward dog. I'm holding on, I can't. Do this one more time, back down to plank. And downward dog. And then walk the hands into the feet. Roll it up. And shake it out. All right. Let's see. Let's grab our dumbbells. Let's start with our bicep curls. I'm going to grab my little 5 pounders for now for my first set. All right. Feet hip width apart. Plant those feet into the ground. Tuck cheeks under. Strong core. Palms up. Bring it up for one. And down. Two. Three. Keep those elbows squeezed into the side. We don't want to be swinging those dumbbells up. Nine and 10. We're gonna go two more. Let's go for 12 today. And bring it down. Feel free to drop your dumbbells, hold them. We're gonna take a quick break, so about 20 to 30 seconds for between these steps. I'm gonna up my weight just a little bit. I'm going to regret it immediately. So for our next set, we're gonna do our hammer curls next. So same thing, roll those shoulders back and down. Nice soft bend in the knees. You want a really strong base of support. Palms face each other. They come up, raise the shoulders, back down. And down for two. Three. Four. Control them coming down. Seven. If you're using a lighter weight, go ahead and go for 12. Or if you feel like going for 12, go for it. And drop those down. Take your break. It is finally starting to get warm in here. And we have our last set of curls in about 15 seconds. It's going to be a wide curl, so our hands are going to be on that diagonal. here does not want to cooperate with me today, guys. Okay, last set. Here we go. We're going to take elbows, squeeze in. They come right out to the side, thanks to two diagonals of the wall. Bring them up, squeeze, down. Control it going down. Three. Four. Five. Six. Eight. Nine. Ten. If you have it, go for two more. And all right, we have single arm rows coming up next. So for this, you want to choose a little bit of a heavier weight. If you don't have a heavier weight, that's okay. You're just going to hinge a little bit further forward so that you have a little bit more gravity working with you. Feel free to stretch out your arms. If you feel like you need a quick little stretch, bring them behind. So I'm going to go. I have a little 15-pounder here since we're doing one arm at a time. Let's start with our right arm first, whatever you want. You're gonna have your left foot in front. Nice split stance here. You can do them just like this, but I like to have a little split stance, left leg with the right arm. Hand, other arm, rest it on your low back so that your back doesn't start to arch here. Nice flat back. From here, throw it up, think bringing it right to your hip. Back down. Elbows stay squeezed into the side the whole time. Like starting on one more. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. And ten. We're gonna swap to the other side. Roll it into that other hand. Nice soft, soft knees. Nice flat back. Try not to arch that back there. I know it's very tempting. Strong core. Throw it up. For one. Two. Three. Four. Drop that weight down, 30 seconds. If you need a drink or a break, go ahead and take it. Take a nice little stretch. Here we go. Right arm, left foot. Here we go. Throw it up one. Two. Seven. Eight. Ten. Here we go. Other side. Right into it. Three, two, one, row. Two more. And ten. Great. One more set of these. Do some arm swings. Wow, hello everybody. All right, left foot. Left foot in front. Okay, whatever I'm doing to get. Inhale. Nice flat back. Throw it up. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. And 10. Like that. Three, two, one, row up, and down to your elbow, close to the thigh, break that hip, six, seven, eight, and 10. All right. 30-second break. And our next exercise is going to be a plank walk out. Push up one, push up two, walk it back up to standing. If you're like me and you prefer knee push-ups, you're gonna drop your knees, do two push-ups on the knees, walk it back up. Okay. So find that position, have some space. Get my little timer. About 30, 40, let's go 40 seconds. How many we can get in. Here we go. And three, two, one. You're gonna bring it forward, hands down, walk it out. Plank, hold that plank for about 1 to 2 seconds. Drop the knees or just use your two push-ups from there. Take it back up, walk it in. Oops. Repeat. If you're feeling like a gold star today, you can do three push-ups. Keep that form going, keep that core nice and tight, flat back. One more. And rest. We're doing good. It's a good day. Today's a good day to have a good day. I woke up this morning and I thought it was Wednesday. It's Thursday. So it's a good day. All right, here we go. Next set. Shake out those arms. Three, two, one, and walk it out. For the try to push up without the knees. Walk it back out. Enjoy the 15 seconds. Hold that plank, drop the knees. So let's do one more, good luck. Walk it out. Three, two, one. And rest. You okay? We are doing good. We are flying through. We're having a good time. Feel free to stretch out those arms. All right, last set. All right, stand it up. Three, two, one, walk it out. Make sure you're breathing throughout this whole movement. All right, one more. Three, two, and one. Finish whatever you are in the middle of and come on back. Seated. And then we are going to stand it up. And we are going to slowly transition into a little bit of lower body. And we are going to have a little bit of a lighter weight here. for a front raise. I know I said lower body. We're going to do a curtsy lunge with one weight. What are we going to do? Opposite hand, opposite leg. So we're going to use our right leg, left hand, comes back, stand, raise. Okay. Bring it back, curtsy, front raise. Okay, remember your front raises don't need to go all the way up here. Just stop right at shoulder height. If you're using a little bit of a heavier weight, nice little bend in the elbow to help get it up there. All right, 10 on each side. Remember for your curtsy, keep that knee facing forward. 3, 2, 1, bring it back. Chest up. 1, 2. Seven, bring it behind, watch that knee. 8, 9, last one. And 10, good hand. You're only gonna be doing 2 sets of these for our curtsies. All right, right leg's coming behind. Bring it back and down. 1. 2. Keep breathing, we got 5 more. Seven, 8, pressing to the heel as you stand. 1 more, and 10. All right, we're gonna do 1 more round of those. I'm gonna try a heavier weight this time. And then after that, we have some squats, a wide squat hold, and touch the ankles. And then have a little bit of core, and then we'll take our nice deep stretch after. Here we go. Left hand, right leg in front. 3, 2, 1, bring it back. Sit it down. 1, 2. Almost there. And 10. 3, 2, 1, bring it back. Stand and lift. 1. 2. Control that lift coming up and down. 4. 5. Keep those shoulders down. 9. Last one. And 10. Yay. Okay. Got through that one. We have, after a quick break, grab some water. We're gonna grab our dumbbells. We're gonna hold them here. Squat to press. Feel free here to do an Arnold press where the palms turn out at the top and they turn back in towards you at the bottom, or just keep them palms together straight up and down. We're gonna do those 2 times as well. bring those weights up. We got 3, 2, 1. Sit those hips back. Press the knees out. Stand. Push 1, 2. This is one of my favorite exercises for you. I see these a lot in our classes. This is really good. Seven. Eight. Nine. And 10. Draw those weights down. Take a second. All right. 5 more seconds. Pick up those weights. Here we go. Feet a little bit wider than hip width. Just a little bit. Pull them up. All right, here we go. Strong core to the back. Press 1, 2. This is how legends are made. This is how legends are made. This is how legends are made. 6, 7. Ooh. I'm feeling it. Yeah. 8, 9. You got 1 more. And 10. Woo. All right, we are doing good. We are doing good. We have a nice wide sumo squat. Coming back, we're gonna hold it for 30 seconds. But while we do that, it's a little harder. All right. So bring it out into your nice wide sumo position. Toes point out or have them face in towards me. It's really whatever preference is yours here. You're going to bring it down into a nice low position. You can be leaning a little bit forward here. Nice flat back. Think of almost like a parallel line. We're here. From here, tap your shin or your ankle if you can get down low enough. Tap. This is while we're keeping a nice flat back. So you don't want to be here. Lift the chest. Tap. Tap. Feel free to also just tap the knees. How low you want to go is up to you. Tapping those ankles is going to make it a little bit deeper position. Tap. 3, 2, 1. Stand it up. Okay. Breathe. We're going to do this one more time. Sorry. 2 more times. Gotcha. Bring it down. Here we go. Nice low. Low squat. Press those hips a little bit forward. Sink shoulders. Above, bring it down to where you stop, and then from there, lean yourself a little forward, reach and tap. Three, two, one, break. Oh, hello, legs. Shake them out. Five more seconds. All right, come on into that position. Here we go, bring it down. Sumo, hold here. Reach and tap. Knees, if you wanna stay upright. Tap, tap, tap. Tap, tap, tap. three, two, one, and break. Oh my gosh. Grab a sip of water if you need it. And we're gonna go down for four to work our core. We're gonna go onto our hands and knees first for our bear crawl, bear hold. So from here, option one, hands into the shoulders, tuck the toes under, lift and hold here. This is level one, bring it back down. If you'd like to make this harder, you're going to pick your knees up. You're gonna send one leg out behind you, bring it back in line. Other leg back out behind you, back in line. So you're gonna be alternating, stepping those legs out. The goal with that is to keep that other leg that's still bent very, very, very close to the floor. I'm talking like an inch to a half inch. As you do this, your knees are gonna wanna pop up a little bit higher. Keep them close. Here we go. We got three, two, one. Bring it up. Just about an inch off the ground. Pull that core in nice and tight. Feel free to add in that step back. Watch those knees, make sure they're staying close. You're just tapping that foot out there. You're not really putting much pressure on that leg that's going back. And break. Drop back to child's pose. We are gonna repeat again. All right, here we go. Three, two, one. Take it up, cut the toes, and lift. This is a great exercise because you feel it in your shoulders, in your quads, in your core. You got 10 seconds left, keep holding it. Those legs are burning, everything's burning. You got it, you got three, two, one. Bring it down, rock it back. We got one more set. This one's gonna be the hardest. Really push yourself. You got 5 seconds off. Give you 5 seconds free. Here we go. Three, two, one. Pick it up. Make sure those shoulders are right over the hands. Keep holding. You got 9 seconds left. You can hold it for 5 seconds. Here we go. Three, two, two and a half, one. Bring it down and back. Bring those feet around. And we are gonna go into some Russian twists side to side. Grab your dumbbell, whichever dumbbell you'd like to use here. You're gonna lean it back. All right, we have 30 seconds of our side to side. You can either pick up the feet or keep them on the ground. Here we go, lift that weight, pull that core in. Inhale, side to side. Feel free to tap that weight on the ground. Whichever way you want to hold it, you can hold it. Whichever way works best for you. Five seconds. And break. Roll it back. We're gonna alternate between these two exercises. So take your dumbbell. You're gonna bring those feet up into the air. Holding the dumbbell with both hands, very securely. Don't drop it. From here, inhale, lift the shoulder blades off the ground, bring it up to the toes. Lift lower. Make this harder, add a pulse. At the top, a double. One, two, down. Eyes up at the ceiling. Rest, bring that weight right back down. We're gonna hold on to it though for the next one. Feet are gonna go back up. If you have a heavier weight here, this is actually gonna help you a little bit more. So I'm gonna grab a heavier one. All right, same thing. We're gonna put that weight up in the air over our chest, feet up from here, one leg at a time or both legs at the same time, down and up. If you notice your low back starts to pop up, one leg at a time. And hold. Lift and lower. If this is still a little bit difficult on your low back, go ahead and bend those legs and tap toes. Modified is here, which you will still feel a whole bunch. Three, two, one, and break. Bring it up. We're gonna repeat through those one more time. Side to side. Three, two, one, twist it out. Nice and slow and controlled. Three, two, one, rest. Grab your dumbbell. We're going to do our dumbbell toe touches. All right, roll it back. Put weight up above the head. Again, make sure you have a very good grip on it before you send it up there. Inhale, lift. And lower. Lift. Try to hold that for a split second at the top. And lower. And break. Bring it down. Almost there. We have our last exercise here, and then we're going to do a glute bridge little combo, and then we're going to do a quick stretch. All right, feet up. Pull that weight up. Secure it. And one leg at a time, or a double leg lift from here. Fight that low back, keep it on the ground. Three, two, one, and break. Yay! All right, this is up for a breather, and then we are gonna roll it back down onto the ground feet. Correct. Feel free to add a dumbbell to your lap here. Roll it back. All right, slide your feet a little further away from your butt, about 6 to 8 inches away. From here, we're gonna pull our belly button down into our spine. Pull that core in nice and tight, squeeze your cheeks together, press through your heels and lift. So that lifting is coming from your tailbone lifting up off the floor. Not about how high you can get up, it's more about that squeeze and keeping that squeeze all the way through your core, down to your glutes, down to your hamstrings. Lift and lower, hold it for about 2 seconds at the top, bring it down. Squeeze, one, two, down. Squeeze, lift, One, two, three more. Weight is in the heels. We're gonna go up and hold. Come on up and hold this position here. Focus where you wanna feel that squeeze. For five, four, three, two, one. Bring it down, bring the feet together, knees apart for our frog bridge. Same thing, we're gonna do about 10, lift and then lower, and then we're gonna hold for 10. Inhale, lift and squeeze, press through those heels. And down, lift, squeeze, two. Four, five, six, seven, eight, ooh, I'm feeling it, nine, 10, we're gonna go up and hold, squeeze, press through those heels, five, four, three, two, one, and take that weight off. If you are using it, roll it to the side. Okay. Lay it down flat. Go ahead and bring those knees into your chest. Just across the ankles, take them in, give them a hug. Rock side to side. And then we're gonna go into our up and down rock. So grab behind the thighs if you'd like. Get a little momentum. Up, roll through. Nice deep breath. Few more rocks. And back down flat. Bring those knees to tabletop. Send that left leg down, right leg comes in. Give it a hug. Cross it up and over to your left. Reach this right arm out to the side. Try to keep both shoulders facing the ceiling. Extend this right leg out straight if you'd like more of a stretch through your hips and down through the side of your quads and hamstrings. Bend it back in. Bring it in. Switch legs. Bend that right leg out. Pull the left in. Ooh, I am sore today. And bring it up and over. And extend it out if you can. My door is too close to me. And bring it back in line. Happy baby, both knees in, reach for the insides of those feet. Reach for the toes or the inside of the heels. Ooh. Definitely a good stretch here. Think of pressing the knees down towards your armpits. And release, send those legs out. We're gonna take our arms above the head. Take a nice little stretch here. Cross your right leg over your left. Arms come through, grab behind your left thigh. Pull that right leg in for a figure four stretch. Feel free to straighten out that left leg or just keep it bent and do some ankle rolls. Roll out those feet. Pull it in a little bit more. And release. Switch legs, left leg over the right. And grab behind that right thigh. And press that elbow into the knee, roll the ankle around. Nice, send it down. Roll it over onto your stomach real quick. Cobra. Press those shoulders away from your ears. all the way down. Lift up a little bit higher. If it feels right for you, go ahead and hold here. Bring it down. We're going to come up and back to our child's pose. Again, choose which one you like best. Toes together, knees apart, or knees right underneath you. From here, take that right arm. We're going to send it through underneath our left. Palm up towards the ceiling. Keep sliding that hand all the way through until you get to that point where you have a nice little twist rotation. Stretching that upper shoulder and scapula. You can bring it up onto the knees or stay on your feet. Hold it here. Take another deep breath. And bring it back in line. Get back, child's pose, and reach it out. And left arm. Send it through. Slide it. Turn and look underneath your smile. Peekaboo. These used to be funny in class. You always turn and there'd be someone saying hi right next to you. Keep sliding that hand through. Take a nice deep breath. Bring it back in line. Up onto all fours. Cat and cow. Hands under those shoulders. We're going to bring it down. Tuck the chin. Lift, press through that spine. Tailbone. And repeat. Exhale. Move. And we'll bring it back to neutral. Bring those feet out in front of you for a nice little hamstring stretch. We are going to start with them just directly right next to each other. Lean it forward, just so that you feel that stretch kick in your hamstring. Hold it here. And let the head hang down, rest the chin, kind of shake your head yes and no. You might notice some tightness back there. Inhale up, we're gonna take the feet, we're just going to open them about pizza slice size. And same thing, we're gonna reach through. Feel free to place your arms right in the middle. Reach through past those feet if you can. Otherwise, you can rest the elbows on the ground. A little bit of a deeper stretch. Inhale up, last time. We're gonna bring those legs out even wider. As you comfortably can go. Doesn't need to be anything crazy. Just targeting those inner thighs, inner groin area. I'm feeling pretty tight in here today, so I'm not going to go too wide. Not going to lean too far. Just until you feel that stretch, hold it. Feel free to hold onto your ankles or reach your hands through the middle. Make sure that your knees are still facing the ceiling and your toes are facing the ceiling. Give them a nice little flex. Bring it down one last time. Inhale, bring those feet in together. Bring your nose to your toes. One last big inhale, press those knees down. Inhale up, take a head roll. Both directions. And shake it out. Nice job, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you have any questions, feel free to type them in the chat or email me. It's not a deal. Have a wonderful rest of your day, everyone.